Amen. But I thought about tonight, amen, that God can help you. Amen. Turn your life around. Amen. I thought about tonight, friend. Amen. It don't matter what kind of life you've lived. Amen. It don't matter how deep in sin you are. It don't matter how far you backslid from God. Brother, tonight, friend. Amen. You apply the blood to your life. Amen. It'll help you. Turn your life around. Amen. You may be out there listening to my voice. Amen. You may be bound down by addictions. You may be afflicted by the things of this world. But one touch from the Master. Amen. Brother can set you free. One touch from the Master. And he'll turn your life around. Amen. Glory be the Lamb of God. The Bible said that Jesus went to his own and his own received him not. They didn't lay out a welcome mat for him. Amen. They didn't welcome him in. But they turned him away. They rejected him. They said, ain't this the carpenter? Ain't his mother? Amen. His sister's here with us. And Jesus said, a prophet is not without honor, but in his own country. And he couldn't do nothing there, but heal a few sick. But I thought about Brother Jonathan. I'm thankful tonight, amen, that God didn't give up. He kept on working, amen, so me and you could be saved. That way, if you're out there listening to my voice and you're bound down by sin, maybe you're sick and troubled, you can be set free by the blood of the Lamb tonight. Amen, tonight, friend, God can help you turn your life around tonight. The Bible said that Jairus came to Jesus. Amen. He was asking, amen, that he touch, amen, his daughter, his one and only, because she lay there and she was about dead. And the Bible said while he was talking, amen, the Bible said, amen, that a ruler, amen, come and said, trouble not the Master, for your daughter's dead. But you see, friend, they didn't know the power of the Master. They didn't know one touch from the Master could give her what she needed.
Yes, sir, he did.
Tonight, one touch from the Master, yes, amen, can give you what you need tonight. Amen. The Bible said that Jesus overheard him. Amen. He said, fear not, but believe. Amen. She shall be made whole. Amen. The Bible said that when he went in the house, amen, he didn't let nobody come in there. Amen. But Peter and John. Amen. The Bible said, amen, the mother and the father of the maiden was allowed to come in. Amen. No doubt because of their unbelief. Because they didn't believe. Amen. Whenever he said, she's not dead, but she's sleeping. Amen. They laughed him. Amen. The scorn. Amen. They thought, who's this man? Amen. They said that because they knew that she was dead. Amen. But Jesus told her to rise. And the Bible said that her spirit came again. Amen, brother, tonight, friend. You may be out there listening to my voice. And you might be spiritually dead. You might be strung out on something. But brother, if Jesus, amen, comes by your way. And you accept him into your life. Brother, he tells you to rise. Just get up and pray. You see this little woman. She was dead. Amen, she was dead. Amen, but Jesus. Let her pass from death to life. Brother, if you're out there and you're lost tonight, you can pass from death, amen, to life with that man called Jesus.
Hey.
Amen. Tonight, God can help you turn your life around. Amen. I thought about that woman with the issue of blood. Amen. I thought about the Bible said that woman, amen, had the issue of blood for 12 years. And the Bible said she sought many physicians. And she spent all that she had. And she never got better. But she got worse. Amen. Until she began to seek after Jesus. A garment. Tonight, when I ain't preaching against doctors. But brother, there's going to come a time in mine in your life. Our brother, when doctors ain't going to do us no good, and the only thing going to help us is if we seek Jesus. What garment tonight, friend? Amen. If you want to be made whole, if you want your life turned around by the blood of the Lamb, our brother, just submit yourself to him and say, here I am, God. I'm willing to serve you.
That's right, brother.
Tonight. Amen. When I got saved, I was sitting at home. Amen. The Lord began to deal with me. Amen. I said, God, amen, I don't know how much of me's left. I said, but however much it is, I'm willing to give it to you. Brother, wherever you are tonight, or whatever kind of shape you're in, if you'll just say, Lord, here I am a sinner. Whatever's left, I'm willing to give to you. Brother, he'll save you. He'll set you free. He'll help you to be born again. Jesus told Nicodemus that a man must be born again. Brother, you have to be born again in order to enter into heaven. Amen. The Bible said in Isaiah, the Lord's hand ain't short that it can't save. Amen, brother. Tonight, the Lord's hand ain't short, amen, that it can't reach away down wherever you are tonight and pick you up out of sin, and pick you up out of the pits of hell, and put you up on a solid foundation, and take away your troubles, and take away your addictions, and take away whatever needs to take away. Brother, tonight, friend, that man called Jesus can touch you at the hospital. He can touch you at the jail. He can bring you from the deathbed. And he can help you to walk again. That's what God, amen, can do for you tonight. Brother, he can reach down to the pits of hell and lift you up tonight.
He can do it, brother.